As Max has said already, my name's Curtis Parvin, and I am Manager of Advanced Statistical Research in the Quality Systems Division at Bio-Rad. I've been with Bio-Rad a little over 4 years now, and this is the third consecutive year where I've given a presentation at this AACC workshop. The previous 2 years, Jim Westgard and I presented. The good news is this year we've added a third speaker, Jay Jones. But because we have three presentations now, I'm limited to 20 minutes. So what I plan to do in the next 20 minutes is discuss with you six effective QC practices that don't require advanced math. Are we all excited about that? Okay. So why do we even need QC? Well, we need QC simply because our test systems fail, right? So how do we decide what QC is appropriate? Well, we need to define the quality required for our tests, and then we implement QC procedures to help assure the quality required is met, even when the test system fails, right? Now, there have been decades of work done on approaches to designing good quality control strategies. I list two of them here. One approach is choose the number of QCs tested and the QC rules to assure a high probability of detecting critical out-of-control conditions. This is the approach that was developed and has been advocated by Jim Westgard for many years now. Another more recent approach developed by me and building on the theories of Dr. Westgard, but trying to directly bring the frequency of quality control testing into the mix is the second approach. Choose the number of QCs tested, the QC rules, and the frequency of QC testing to assure that the expected number of unreliable patient results produced is not too high. Now, both of these approaches are effective at helping a laboratory design a quality control strategy that will mitigate the risk of producing unreliable patient results in the event of an out-of-control condition. But both approaches require some serious mathematical computations and can only really be done with the assistance of computer software. So Bio-Rad challenged me for this year's presentation to try to put together a presentation that would discuss or describe effective QC practices that don't require advanced math to either understand or to implement. So I set about thinking, trying to put together a list of easy to implement but scientifically sound QC practices based on the insights I've gained over the many years of research I've done in statistical quality control. I then took that list and tried to pare it down to a manageable number and decided upon six recommended practices that I'll discuss with you today. These six practices, none of them require advanced math to understand or to implement. Implementing any of them is straightforward. You can choose to go home tomorrow and decide that you wanted to implement any of these six practices. Now, while they won't provide an optimal QC strategy, they can do as good a job as the two approaches that I described on the prior slide, requiring the more advanced mathematical computations in the computer software. While they won't provide an optimal QC strategy, they should move you in the right direction. Now, some of these practices that I'll discuss are things that maybe some of you already do. A number of them might seem obvious and intuitive. Others might seem counterintuitive, but they're all based on sound statistical quality control principles.